In order to make this extreme hair growth oil, you will need just three natural ingredients. Okay, guys, if you're interested, please stay tuned. And if you're new to the channel, please consider subscribing and give us a thumbs up. And I'll see you in the tutorial. Make sure to follow me on all my social media platforms right here, and let's start. So you will need your aloe vera, guys. I'm using my fresh aloe vera that I got from my Arab store here in my city. And guys, this is so expensive here in Sweden. A leaf like this will go for close to $5. So, but I'm excited and I'm happy that I finally got where I could buy it, and I'm not complaining at all. So I'm just going to take out the sides of the aloe vera, and I'll use a tissue to just clean the yellowish part that comes from the aloe vera when you cut it. I heard it's poisonous, so I do away with that. And I'm just going to slice my aloe vera right now and chop it into smaller sections. Okay, now you can use aloe vera in so many different ways, as a pre-poo, as a shampoo, as a conditioner, as a styler, as a detangler, as a treatment. Okay, now aloe vera is very great on your hair because it contains what is known as proteolytic enzymes, which repair dead skin cells on your scalp. It also acts as a great conditioner and leaves your hair really smooth and shiny and soft. And it promotes hair growth, it prevents itchy scalp, it reduces dandruff, and it conditions your hair really, really nicely. And for today's video, I will be using my healthy aloe vera right here. You don't need to use this much. I had the big stem that I didn't want to be stingy, so I wanted my oil to be much, because the girls are going to come back from holiday. So the next ingredient is my mint leaves. This is fresh from the supermarket in the vegetable area. You can just pick your mint leaves from there. I plucked about 5 stems that I'm just plucking the leaves right now. Wash it, guys. Make sure you wash it to take away any bacteria or whatever dirt that is on it. And I'm just going to slice it and add it to the aloe vera. I am using mint in this tutorial because I recently read a lot about mint leaves, and it helps with dandruff. Like, when they want to give you one step cure to dandruff, it's only mint leaf I see. Okay, I'll make a complete tutorial on how to deal away with just dandruff. So the next ingredient right here is my rosemary leaves that I got right here. I got it in the Arab shop as well, in the tea section where you have herbal tea. So this was my rosemary tea in a bag. You saw in me plucking off from the packet in another video that you guys will see. So I took just a cup, 50 ml of the rosemary flower leaves right there, about 2 tablespoons. So yeah, so this is it. So these are the 3 main natural herbs that we'll be using for this tutorial. I'll go ahead, just transfer it into my blender, and I'm going to blend that. Now, if you're watching right up to this moment and you are not yet subscribed, baby girl, no do your girl like this now, please just click that red subscribe button there, give us a thumbs up, and click the notification bell as well, so you'll be notified each time we upload a new video. And the thumbs up is to help YouTube to recommend my videos to other ladies searching for such natural hair growth recipes, tutorials, and they will get to know about the channel. And you guys, you need to push me to 100k subscribers before the end of this year. Okay, guys, thank you so much for subscribing. I love you, and I love reading your comments as well. So I'm adding right now my extra virgin olive oil, which conditions my hair, moisturizes my hair, and it leaves my scalp really nice, and it works with dandruff as well, guys. So I love, love, love my extra virgin olive oil. You can use whatever oil you want. I don't like using coconut oil all the time here because my oils will always solidify, because here in Sweden it is so cold that your oil will solidify. So I added just a little bit of coconut oil, I think 2 tablespoons of my extra virgin coconut oil. This is the coconut oil you use in cooking, so it is pure coconut oil, guys. So if it was not the temperature right here, it will be liquid form. I don't have time to always melt it before I use it. So guys, one mistake I did was to do a double boiler method. It did not work for this oil at all. The whole thing was just heating up. I was not seeing the mixture producing oil, so I transferred it directly into my frying pan and I put it on low heat, and everything, like, look at how the aloe vera gel just melted into my oils. And I did this for 15 to 20 minutes to get this like this. And guys, I let it cool for a while, and after that I'm going to sifter it, strain it with your dome cap or your wig cap, your cheesecloth, so you don't get any particles into your oils. Okay, now one more thing, guys, do not strain it or press it too hard, because the aloe vera still has a little bit of water in it, and I had some traces of water in my oil that I just had to leave it to settle for a while, and then I strain it. You are going to see all that in a bit. So if you look carefully at the bottom of this bowl, you will see the reddish liquid under the oil. That's like water that I have to remove, which is the aloe vera. So I'm going to strain it carefully. This method didn't work completely because I didn't want the liquid into the bowl, so I used a spoon to just scoop it out, and now I'm going to transfer it into my applicator bottle. Now my oil is free from any water traces in it, and it's good to go into my applicator bottle right here. And let's apply this right now. So the next day I had a party to attend. This is my sewing thread, guys, that I always tell you about. I use it all the time to do my African threading, okay, because I don't have the real African threading here in Sweden, so I use this one. Almost think twice. So I'm using my spray right here to just add moisture into my hair. This was midweek, so I didn't wash my hair. My hair was clean. I'm just adding moisture, prepping my hair, stretching it before the day before my party. And once I do that, I'm going to grab my oil right there and just apply it on the section. I didn't want too much oil because I was traveling and all, you know. So I applied it on the section, and after that I'll just grab my African thread that I've prepped, make sure I detangle it with my white tooth comb because I had to go with my updo the next day. So yes, look at how shiny and detangled and soft and luscious my hair is looking right now. Oh my goodness. So try this, let me know in the comment section if you've used this. I'm going to do this all over my hair and just put my hair in my cap, and I go to bed. The next day I styled it for my party, and I don't know, let me insert a picture right here so you can see how I was looking.